not lightly. Master, we come bowing before your holy and righteous feet, saying, have thine own way. Lord, you be the potter and help us to be moldable clay. Now, God, we pray that revival will take place over and over again in our lives. And we might hear from you even on tonight. Thank you for the presence, the power, amen, the work of the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
Pray, God, that the words of our mouth and the meditation of our hearts would be acceptable in thy sight. O Lord, our strength and our redeem. Every saved soul said amen.
Amen.
And praise God. Amen. Thank you so much. John chapter 16. Beginning with verse number 8. And reading through verse number 15. John chapter 16, verse 8 through verse number 15. Amen. John 16, verses 8 through 15. It says, and when he has come, he will convict the world of sin.
Yes.
And of righteousness. And judgment of sin because they do not believe in me, of righteousness because I go to my Father and you see me no more, of judgment because the ruler of this world is judged. I still have many things to say to you, but you cannot bear them now. However, when he, the Spirit of truth, has come, he will guide you into all truth.
Yes. Amen.
He will not speak of his own authority. But whatever he hears, he will speak. He will tell you things to come. He will glorify me. But he will take of what is mine and declare it to you.
Yes. Amen.
All things that the Father has are mine. Therefore I said that he will take a mind and declare it to you. Amen. Tonight's message, the work of the Holy Spirit. Amen. To your neighbor and say, neighbor, the work. The work of the Holy Spirit. In this 16th chapter of John, Jesus is getting his disciples ready for the time when he would leave them. And as he is preparing his disciples, we find here that the Lord is making clear that the Holy Spirit will take a more active role within the lives of his people and in the world. Says in verse number 8, and when he is come. Jesus was foretelling of the day of Pentecost, when the Holy Spirit would come in as a mighty rushing wind, fill the house, that they would speak with other tongues. The Bible says that they would be filled with the Holy Spirit. When he is come, that says something to all of us on tonight. That characterizes how the Holy Spirit works in our lives. Amen. The Holy Ghost must come to us. And as Christians, as believers, we must be open and receive him. Yes, when you accept Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, the Holy Spirit comes into your life. But the reality of it is that he may not yet have full control. You really have to ask yourself, does the Holy Ghost have complete control over your life? When he has come, when he takes over, your nature changes, your behavior changes, your attitudes change. Your faith level goes to another degree.
like that in church.
Yes, you are moving, but you are not moving at the level that you should.
Yeah.
And so what has happened is that the Holy Spirit has to fully take over. That ought to speak to us when he is coming.
Yeah.
And I come tonight to tell you that the Holy Ghost is still working. If you will allow him to work inside of your life.
Yeah.
One of the things that Jesus says is that the Holy Spirit will convict our lives.
Yeah.
Yes, yes.
That word convict means to bring to shame in order that we might repent of sin.
Yeah.
A lot of people today really don't have conviction in their lives. We see it all the time in church. We have announcements. We have programs. We have rituals. We have meetings. We have organization and order. But what about the conviction of the Holy Ghost? Yes, a lot of people want to stand up and give a testimony, and all of that is good. A lot of people want to talk, and all of that is wonderful. But how many of us want to say today, I've come in here to be convicted by the Holy Ghost. Tim Similar, he wrote a book called Fresh Wind, Fresh Fire.
Right.
And then he talked about how there was a man, and he was angry, made up his mind, he's going to go and shoot somebody.
Right.
But he decided before he would go and commit the deed that he'd stop in at the church.
Oh.
And he stopped in at the church and heard the preacher preaching. He was convicted by the Holy Spirit. He came down the aisle and laid that gun on the altar and said, Lord Jesus, forgive me. I'm giving my life to Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
Come in tonight to tell you that's what the Holy Ghost does when you really let him work in your life. You can't come in contact with Jesus and stay the same. Something's got to change on the inside. You can really have a conviction of the Holy Spirit when your mind on sin when you start church and your mind still on sin after church is over. That's where along the line the Holy Ghost ought to talk to you. Say, listen, brother, listen, sister, you are not new. Somewhere the Holy Ghost ought to cause you to see yourself in the mirror and examine yourself and say, Lord, I want to be right in my life. Amen. The Holy Spirit ought to move you to repent of sin.
Glory.
Yes. And this Friday today, now folks seem like no one is in sin. Everybody is all right. Everybody is saved. And that's because the Holy Spirit is not working in that life. That's right.
Yeah.
years ago, amen, and I did a funeral, and after the funeral, I went over to the family's house, and while there, it seemed like all of a sudden they wanted to rush me off the campus and call me on a leave. I couldn't really understand what it was all about. They said, Pastor, thank you for your service. That was a fine service. All of this. And I thought, you're right there trying to push me out the door. Pastor, you want something to eat? You want me to wrap it up? No, sit down, Pastor. Just take it on with me.
Red ribbons,
and see the red and be scared away and leave. you can't get yourself right.
Yes.
So many people say, I'm coming to church once I get right. Jesus said, you need the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
He's real. He comes into your life.
Yes, sir.
He gives you a desire for that which is God. Then the Holy Spirit even brings about conviction concerning judgment.
Uh-huh.
That the judge or the ruler of this world, who is Satan, certainly will be judged. Holy Spirit lets us know that following the ways of the world lead to hell. Every now and then we need to be reminded that there is a hell. But yes, there is also a hell. We need to know that Satan is judged. He's condemned on his way to hell. But all of those that follow after Satan, all of those that reject the power of the Holy Spirit, will also have that part in the lake of fire. So often we don't want to talk about hell anymore. Everybody now is going to hell. Everybody now is saved, and you can just about go to heaven anyhow. But the Holy Spirit says something different. Holy Spirit says without Jesus, our destiny is hell. Judgment day comes. And all of us who have the Holy Spirit, Jesus Christ. For what is profit a man if he shall gain the whole world and still lose his soul? Holy Spirit reminds us we're going to be judged one day. We want to be ready when we stand before the King. But then the Holy Spirit is also our guide. As we speak the truth of God's word, what it does, that truth guides us into all truth and righteousness. And I love that about a good guide. A good guide will get you to your destination. We were trying to get here, Pastor Moran, and we said, well, put the address in the GPS. The GPS what will bring you to your destination. I come here tonight to tell you there's a greater GPS. Yes. His name is the Holy Ghost. He guides us into all the truth. We need to learn how to follow our guide. So many want to guide themselves. But my prayer is that we'll follow the guide of the Holy Ghost. Sometimes the Holy Ghost will say, turn around. You've gone too far. You need to make a U-turn. Sometimes the Holy Ghost will say, exit to the right.
Yes, sir.
I move over and get over in another land. But follow the truth of the Holy Spirit. Beautiful thing about God's guide is that the Holy Ghost does not speak a man on his own authority. For God. He is yourself. You see, you got too many in church that speak of their own selves. They talk about what they've done themselves. They talk about where God has brought them from. They talk about what God is doing in their life. But when you're led by the Holy Ghost, you move yourself out of the way. And you start talking about sweet Jesus. conviction to be righteous. Conviction to be judged. Under the guidance of the Holy Spirit that leads us into all truth and gives us the privilege to declare His glory. That souls be saved. That lives be delivered. And that people come to follow the works of the Holy Spirit. Lord, we thank you for the word. Thank you tonight for the power to preach your word. Thank you, Lord, for working in our lives. Father, we repent of our sin. We accept your forgiveness. We are convicted and ashamed of what we are doing. But Lord, tonight we want to be righteous. Humble us, O God, under your mighty hand. That when we leave here tonight, we'll leave under the work of the Holy Spirit. This is our prayer in the name of Jesus we pray. Amen. Thank God. The door of the church is open. There's somebody here tonight. I want to invite you to come quickly by the power of the Holy Spirit. You are already saved, but tonight is a night of conviction. To say, Lord, I'm ashamed of what I'm doing. And I want to be righteous. That when I am judged, that I would know that I'm saved. God will be pleased with my life. Tonight is your night. If you're here, we're going to invite the choir to come to my left.